So our fatty acid is activated to fatty acyl coenzyme A. This is the cytosolic site. This is the membrane of the mitochondrion. This is the matrix. Remember, mitochondrion consists of two membranes. This is the outer membrane, which is near to the cytosol, and there is an inner membrane near to the matrix. There is an inner membrane space in between. Okay, is it clear to you? Now, you see, fatty acyl coenzyme A cannot simply pass across the two membranes into the matrix. It needs some more machinery. There is what we call carnitine. Can you see here something called carnitine? This carnitine is a type of a molecule required for transportation of this fatty acyl coenzyme A. First of all, the fatty acyl coenzyme A reacts with carnitine and it is releasing coenzyme A. So, fatty acyl group is transferred from the coenzyme A towards the carnitine. Now, what do we have here? We have fatty acyl carnitine. Fatty acid combined with the carnitine to form fatty acyl carnitine. And where is this reaction taking place? In this diagram, it is seen that this reaction is taking place on the outer mitochondrial membrane. And what is this? This is carnitine acyl transferase 1, the enzyme which is catalyzing the transfer of fatty acid from fatty acyl coenzyme A to carnitine. And actually, look here. Look here. After fatty acyl carnitine is formed at the outer membrane or in the inner membrane space. This is very important because this fatty acyl coenzyme A can freely move across the outer membrane up to the inner membrane space, but not thereafter. That means this transfer of the fatty acid from the coenzyme A to the carnitine can take place either on the outer membrane of the mitochondrion or in the inner membrane space. Now what happens? What is formed is fatty acyl carnitine, and that reaction, that transfer of the fatty acid to the carnitine is catalyzed by the enzyme carnitine acyl transferase 1. Now this carnitine carrying the fatty acid is moving into the matrix of the mitochondrion. How? There is a transporter molecule. Can you see this transporter molecule? It is almost rose in color, this transporter molecule. Through this one, the fatty acyl carnitine is moving into the matrix. This is the matrix. There, this fatty acid is again transferred from the carnitine to a coenzyme A. You see, this is the fatty acyl carnitine, this is a coenzyme A, they are reacting, the fatty acid is transferred from the carnitine to the coenzyme A, forming once again fatty acyl coenzyme A. And this transfer of the fatty acid from the carnitine is carried out by the enzyme, is catalyzed by the enzyme carnitine acyl transferase 2. And where is it present? On the matrix side of the mitochondrion. Now that our carnitine is free, it is moving back through the transporter to the inner membrane space, to the outer membrane, so that it can bring another molecule of fatty acid. So actually what happened here? Here there is a fatty acyl coenzyme A in the cytosol. Here there is a fatty acyl coenzyme A in the matrix of the mitochondrion. So effectively, this fatty acyl coenzyme A is transported from the cytosol to the matrix. Of course, that involves carnitine transporter, and transporter protein is there, and carnitine acyl transferase 1 and carnitine acyl transferase 2. Remember, carnitine acyl transferase is present either on the outer membrane of the membrane, or we can say in the inner membrane space, but not within the inner membrane or in the matrix. At the same time, carnitine acyl transferase 2 is present towards the matrix side of the membrane. So now the fatty acyl coenzyme A is in the matrix of the mitochondrion, and now it can be broken down by means of beta oxidation to release two carbon units, which we call acetyl coenzyme A.